Hey, it's Mikey, and welcome to yet another easy camo guide. This time, it's for the newest assault rifle, the Fera 83. You get the Fera at tier 15 at the Season 2 Battle Pass, so by now, most of you guys should already have it. And all said and done, getting gold on this weapon, it's relatively easy to unlock. It's a little bit time-consuming. I'd say around 6-plus hours, give or take. And that's assuming you pop some double weapon XP tokens or you just play during an XP event. If you're watching this in the future, you don't have any weapon XP tokens in Cold War, what you could do is load up Warzone and see if you have any weapon tokens in there. If you played Modern Warfare last year, those tokens will show up under Warzone. And any tokens popped under Warzone can be active under Cold War. If your console doesn't have enough room for Warzone, just load it up on your PC since it's free to play. Activate the tokens there. Obviously, you want to log in into your Activision account. And keep in mind, you cannot be logged in into PC and console at the same time. So pop the token there, shut it down, and then move over back to console. So with that all said, let's just get started. And in case you're new here, I tend to unlock all my weapon challenges first before I attempt to do this in a public match. The main reason for that is many of these challenges, they're almost the same thing, or they can synergize really well and they can be completed at the same time. So why would you do the same challenge twice, essentially? All right, so speaking of the challenges, let's go over them very quickly for everybody. First up is spray. Get 300 eliminations with the Fera. Onto stripes, which is get 100 headshots. After that is classic, that is get 5 kills without dying 20 times, all kills coming from the Fera. Then it is geometric, get 50 long shots. On to flora is kill 75 enemies detected, stunned, or blinded by your scroll streaks, equipment, or field upgrades in multiplayer. Then it is science, probably the hardest one, shoot and kill 50 enemies taking cover from you in multiplayer. And then psychedelic, kill 2 or more enemies rapidly 25 times in multiplayer. And like I said, many of these can be combined. I'll talk about that in a minute, but obviously you can see spray, stripes, classic, they can all be done relatively at the same time. I mean, all of them could kind of be done at exactly the same time, and that is why we want to save time and hit weapon level 50 before we do these in a public match. And that is the first step, unlocking everything first. Great thing about Cold War, zombies mode can be used to rank up your weapon to level 50, and once you hit weapon level 50, all the challenges are unlocked. And with the last update, we have a new mode called Outbreak, so let's load that up. Go to zombies. And here it is, we have Outbreak. Of course, you could really play any zombies mode, but well, except for Dead Ops. But Outbreak is the newest one. It's pretty fun. That is the gameplay we see in the background. And Outbreak is just, or zombies in general, it's just more chill, a way more simpler way to level up your gun. People in public matches, they have all their attachments unlocked, the best loadouts, and it's just kind of not fair. That's why I prefer zombies, way more fun. But hey, if you just want to play nothing but multiplayer, you do you. But it's, in my opinion, it's just not that fun. So I played a combination of Outbreak and other regular zombie modes. So once your Fera is ranked 50, not only will your challenges be unlocked, but so will most of the attachments. And that way you'll stand a better chance in public games. And as usual, my streaks from here on out are spy plane and the counter spy plane. Those are the two that we need for Flora, so why not just run those both? Very simple, doesn't distract you from your goal of getting golden camo. So you can work on these challenges in whatever order that you like. Me, I decided to work on the most boring ones, the harder ones, and that is Geo. Get 50 long shots, and kind of sort of related is science, kill 50 enemies who are behind cover. So here is my class. Let's go over the setup. So the optic can be really whatever you like. Yeah, I was using the thermal just to kind of mix it up a little bit, but really anything with some kind of zoom, the axial is really good. I recommend the axial if you're not really into the thermal. but really anything with some sort of 2x, 1.7, whatever it is that you like. The scope honestly doesn't matter. For the muzzle, I did like the Spetsnaz for the plus 12% vertical. Yeah, it has negative 8 horizontal, but we're gonna make up for that a little bit later. For the barrel, I have the 18.7 Spetsnaz, and it has plus damage, but mainly the real reason why I like it is the plus 50% effective damage range and the plus 50 bullet velocity. The bullet velocity is gonna keep it so the bullet has a minimal drop. That's the main thing. Yeah, the downsides is vertical recoil, horizontal, the max starting ammo, but I kind of don't care when we're playing hardcore where it's one shot, one kill. Okay, so that kind of doesn't really affect us. Body, I do have the steady aim laser just to come in clutch. I don't like any of the revealed distance ones because they show a flashlight, and I don't like that. I don't like being spotted. And these are all just suggestions. You guys can use whatever you like. I'm just trying to help you out what worked best for me. The Spetsnaz grip for the plus 6% vertical, plus 20 horizontal. I don't care about the shooting movement speed because we're gonna be camping for the most part. We're doing long shots. Magazine, I guess, doesn't matter too much, but I don't like the ones that affect our ADS. That's why I just went with the 40 rounder. Again, doesn't really matter too much, but I would stay away from anything that affects your ADS when it's hardcore. In hardcore, you kind of want to aim down sight really quick. Then we have the handle. I do have the Serpent Wrap for the plus 25% ADS time. Sprint to fire goes down, but who cares? We are not running and gunning. We got our s'mores out, we're camping. And then I have the Raider stock mainly for the plus 40% aim walking movement speed. Makes it so fun to duck in and out and cover. Gunfighter wild card. That is how you're able to have all those attachments. Tactical, whatever you like. I happen to have stem shot. I happen to have frag. But from here on out, at least until you're working on Flora, the Flora camo, gotta have that field mic. The field mic, mainly to mark people, put it in a high traffic area, put it by the B flag, put it wherever you think people will be. I picked the field mic over this jammer because if someone is running an anti-jammer perk like Spycraft, it isn't gonna count. Yeah, that's kind of weird, right? That or it's a bug. Field mic, the kills will always count. That's a shame because the jammer is 2 minutes, 30 seconds. The field mic is 3:30, but it is what it is. Use a field mic, you're guaranteed to get those Flora camo kills. Perks, first perk can be really anything, I suppose. Paranoia could work, flak, attack, whatever you like. Perk two, I have assassin, and that's mainly so I can get my spy plane, counter spy plane, but I suppose it really doesn't matter too much. Really your choice, but I do highly, highly recommend going with cold-blooded. No need to worry about score streaks. A lot of these things, I guess, are up to you, but ninja seems like a waste since we're gonna be, you know, chilling at a distance. So, like I said, Geo and Science camo challenges, they kind of work together since a lot of enemies who are at a distance, they tend to be in a window, they tend to be taking cover. Play that big boat map armada, play that if you want. You can hang out in your spawn, you can hang out by the B flag, hang out near one of the balconies, and you're almost always gonna see people in windows. And as long as you're far enough, long shots should be pretty easy to hit, whether you're in your spawn or from the middle aiming into their spawn. And of course, because we unlocked everything, we're working on all kinds of other challenges. Flora, headshots, bloodthirsty, all that stuff. And just always, always, always try to train yourself to always aim for the head. In hardcore, it's gonna be one bullet. It's awesome. Hardcore mode all the way. That's all I did was play hardcore. Hardcore Dom was mainly what I played since the spawns are predictable. If you're not into hardcore domination, you can play hardcore KC. Those two modes work really well. But hardcore domination, I mean, it's just so predictable. So very simple, not much more to say. After the long shots, I worked on science. That is kill enemies behind cover. Here is my class. Only 5 attachments, optic, whatever it is you prefer. I just so happen to use a Hawksmoor. Sometimes I would use the Axial, but honestly, It's your choice. Body, steady aim. Steady aim laser is just pretty much there to come in clutch. I will be on Nuketown most of the time. It just comes in clutch for those, you know, those random encounters that you have. You bump into somebody. The magazine, I guess it doesn't matter, but I did like the 40 rounder for the handle. I really, really did like the GRU, mainly for the plus 30 ADS. That's really nice. But honestly, it doesn't matter too much. It's Nuketown. You know, what can you expect? And then I did like the KGB for the plus 40% aim walking movement speed and the plus 30 sprint to fire. Yeah, the hip fire goes down, but we do have the laser sight to counter that. The aim walking movement speed, that's just going to help duck in and out of cover. Frag is just a personal preference. And of course, the field mic, always using that to get those flora challenges in the background. Perk setup, it's pretty much the standard issue. Flak and tack for perk one. No need to explain that. Perk two is kind of whatever you like. You can have assassin to get your streaks, gearhead to get your gear, and then quartermaster to get your equipment. Scavenger, you're just not gonna live long enough, honestly, to need the ammo. And tracker, you already know where everyone is. They're in the house. Cold-blooded works really well, lets you camp, don't have to worry about you know, helicopters, sentry guns, all that stuff. Gunko could be nice. Ninja could be very nice. I do like spycraft since we're kind of going to be campy and we kind of want to make use of our mini map. So spycraft will keep you from being jammed. So yes, I ended up playing hardcore Nuketown 24/7. That was for science, people taking cover from you. And on Nuketown, we've all played it throughout the years. We already know all the spots to take cover. Up in the window, on the Jeep to the side, the B flag boxes, or the truck in the middle. Four major, major spots where people take cover from you. Very predictable. And in hardcore, it's one shot, one kill. It just made the most sense to speed this up. Really not much more to say there. And assuming you have been running the spy plane, counter spy plane, and the field mic this entire time, you should be ready to move on to the final challenge, which is headshots. Here's my headshot setup. It's kind of sort of similar to Nuketown. Attachments, really you want stuff that will allow you to ADS quick or have a clear point of view. I did prefer the Micro Flex LED, nice and clear. Steady aim laser comes in clutch. Magazine, it can really be whatever works best for your playstyle. 40 rounder or the tape mag. Either of these first two work out great. The handle, I did have the serpent wrap for plus 25% aim down sight. We do have a negative 10 sprint to fire, but let's move on to the stock. And then from there, we have the KGB skeletal for the plus 30 sprint to fire, and then the plus 40 aim walking movement speed. It's awesome. And yeah, negative on the hip fire, but our goal is for headshots, so we really shouldn't be relying on hip fires. Anyways, very solid setup. I do recommend this. Here is the equipment I had. I did have the stem shot. Believe it or not, you will get hit marked sometimes. Grenade, try not to use it. And by now, you should be done with flora, so no more need for the field mic. Trophy system, 1 minute, 20 second cooldown, and it will stop a lot of projectiles. Just kind of throw it off spawn, really, or anywhere that you think is pretty clever. Get yourself some XP. Class setup, very, very similar to Nuketown. Flak and tack, obvious reasons, you know, people are gonna throw random stuff. Gearhead, quartermaster, and then gung-ho and ninja. There's really no need for ghost, cold-blooded, spycraft, because the mode we are playing does not have streaks. And that's the thing, I use one of my favorite modes to get headshots done. Hardcore face-off, no square streaks to worry about, nowhere to hide, very fast. And I've been able to hit close to 30 headshots in a single game. Link down below to that gameplay if you want to check it out. It's just way too good, lots of fun, and hopefully they keep it around for the next COD. I love it a lot. Headshots aside, it's really fun. And there you go, easy gold on the Pharah. Stay tuned for more camo guides. Leave a like if you enjoyed it and check out these other cool videos. And of course, the live stream, link down below to the Twitch.